Hello everyone, welcome back to our second session all together. How was your break? Did you enjoy during your break? Was your break great? Was your break fun? Was your break funny? It might be yes, it was. Some of you might say no, it wasn't, right? And some of you say it's maybe, or some of you might say it's a little bit bored, right? Because you cannot go to school and play with friends. All right. Anyway, I hope that you don't feel much bored even as you stay at home. Now let's move back to our second lesson all together. And according to our schedule today, you are going to learn about grammar Galaxy 1, right? Unit 10, I missed the school bus. So you already learned about simple past of this verb, right? So you have learned already about regular verb, right? So regular verb, we refer to verb that never change form. And regular verb always add most other verb at ed, right? So we use simple past to talk about something that happened in the past, or something that already happened in the past, right? So we call simple past. In the previous time, you have learned with two forms of the simple past already. They are affirmative form and negative form. So affirmative form, subject plus verb 2 plus of object, and negative form, subject plus did not plus verb base, or because of verb 1 plus of object. So verb base, we refer to the verb that never change form, the verb that we use as the original verb. All right, so today you are going to learn about a simple past again. So we finish about the last form, we focus on question form, right? So our question form today is about did plus subject plus verb base. As I have mentioned already, verb base, we refer to the verb that never change form, or we can call it the original verb. It acts like to infinitive. All right, and plus blah blah plus question mark. So now let's move to our example all together. Did you eat my cake last night? So did you eat my cake last night? And then you say that, you might say, no, I didn't. This one, we have two pronunciations. You can pronounce didn't or did, based on what I have explained you on Friday already, right? We have two pronunciations. You can pronounce didn't or two syllable didn't. All right. So the question starts from you, so the answer should be I. So this one, I just remind you again and again to make sure that you don't forget about this point. Because when the question starts from you, the answer should be I. And when the question starts with I, so the answer should be you. All right, so now let's move to I. Did I eat your cake last night? And then you can see that the answer should be you, because the question starts with I, right? And then say, yes, you did. So why here we say did, why here we say didn't? Because this one is a negative form. This one is with yes, it can be affirmative form. And one more thing, the question starts with did, so the answer also did. If the question starts with was or were, the answer should be was or were here, or weren't or wasn't here, right? If the question starts with can, the answer should be can or cannot here, right? So the verb that used after subject based on the verb that stand at the beginning of a sentence here. All right, now let's go to number 3. This is a little bit special for you today, because subject we have two ways to answer to. All right, so did we have exam last night? Did we have exam last night? You can answer yes, we did, or yes, you did. So why you have two answers, can be you, can be we. When you ask this question among of your group, okay, among of your group or among a member in your group, the answer should be we. But if among of your group no one know about this answer, and you want to ask this question to another one else, right? So you don't ask the question to a member in your group, but you ask this question to someone else about this one. So someone else might say you, and you, he is plural. All right, everyone. So now let's go to number 4. Did she study yesterday? Did she study yesterday? So no, she didn't. Based on what you have learned with the yes no question, third person singular and plural, we don't change the subject with the answer. So when the question starts with she, the answer should be she. The question starts with it, the answer should be it. The question starts with they, the answer also they too. Like you can see now, find here, did they come? Yes, sorry here, no number. Yes, they did. So yes, they did, right? So yes, they did. Then you can see here, third person singular or plural, we don't change the subject with the answer. Only second person, first person, and first person plural, that we might change the subject based on what you ask in the situation. Alright everyone, I hope that you can understand about how to answer with the yes no question of did in the past. Right? So now let's go to our practice today. Write the verbs in the correct boxes in their simple past form. So you can open your book on page 35 in the workbook. Here you practice in your workbook here. You can see the word. Here there are 8 words that you have to write in the correct boxes here. It is mean that what you have to write, what you have to complete is about here, right? So I hope that you can complete the answer here and then submit to your homeroom teacher about today's practice. Now our second session also finished, but at the end of the lesson, I would like to say that please don't forget to review about your previous lesson or your old lesson, because your exam is coming soon tomorrow, right? It is coming tomorrow. So I hope that you can read the book and review about the lesson. Be ready for your exam tomorrow. All right, everyone. So now our today's lesson is finished. See you again tomorrow. Goodbye, everyone.